Krav Maga is a self-defense, defense and tactics system. It's not really like a martial art, because in martial art you're going to learn a lot of techniques that are passed from one generation to the other. And there's usually a spiritual aspect and something more of a character improvement, which is good. But in Krav Maga, our only concern is self-defense, is for you to survive a violent confrontation and to go home alive. Krav Maga Ottawa has been active for over 2 years as an official school licensed by the IKMF, and this is growing obviously in Ottawa as well. So we're always welcoming new people. You can come and try a class, you can come and but again, if what you want is only to learn to defend yourself, that's what we teach here. We don't teach anything that is more spiritual or anything like that. We teach you to defend yourself in the streets against all kinds of situations.
I work late nights and I go into an empty parking lot. I'm no longer quite as scared as I used to be. I know to look around, I know what I need to do and how to act in case I ever need to problems.
Usually it gives you confidence in a lot of situations and probably teaches you to avoid situations where you might have problems. It's a good group of people, safety is paramount, respect for your partner, and all in all it's a well-run organization.
Well, in the past year I guess Krav Maga has made me more proactive when I'm walking home from work or at night or in a parking lot. I look around a lot more, and I think the principles of Krav Maga, even though maybe I'm not the strongest person out there, I think the basic principles really teach you how to defend yourself in pretty much any situation.
What do you think it's important for a woman, especially to do Krav Maga?
Because women are easy targets. They're very susceptible to larger men coming to attack them. Also, carrying purses or very cell phone and whatnot, it's easy to attack, so it's a great way to learn how to defend yourself and avoid problems.
I do a lot of traveling, and you never know what situations you're going to be put into when you're in a foreign country, or even when you're in Ottawa. You never know if somebody's going to attack you or come at you. If you're working downtown, you never know what can happen.
Combat is a more advanced phase of Krav Maga. Usually people do a combat after they learn the basic principles of attacking and defending. In my class I teach how to handle combat properly. I teach you tactics, I teach you strategies that you can use to finish the fight very fast.
This is walking defense. So when the knife comes on this one, I send my hand at the hook away from me. Comes to stab me, body defense, hand defense, immediately kick, punch, and I can move away.
Maybe after a while you're tired to go to the ground, you can do it up, take the knife. It works. You can do it sideways and take the knife.
Amy Liefenfeld was the person who invented krav maga during the Second World War. Okay? It was invented in the streets of Bratislava to fight against the Nazis back then, the youth fascists there. And Amy's, what he wanted, his vision for the world was so that men may walk in peace. And that's what we do. We try to give you tools so that you can walk in peace, so that if someone comes to attack you, to steal from you, to bother you, anything, you can defend yourself and you can go home.